regain past life's memories, but also to channel my higher self and channel the, I wouldn't say aliens, but our future human selves. Yeah, channeling our future human selves so I can give information to you guys and give my own thoughts and perspectives on what I believe that people should hear. And the reason I choose not to channel aliens or, well, not aliens, I would call them more, well, the beings I channel with is more, crap, now I just forgot their name, brain fart, but, yeah, I think they're called, not Adronis, not Pleiadians, although I do feel like I've connected with them before. But, Syrians, I believe. Because I am, in my mind, I'm thinking of the color blue. And the first thing that comes to my mind is Sirius and Orion. So, I do believe that's I connect with the most, but I don't want to channel extraterrestrials because I just feel like that's what almost everybody does now. That's what everybody I just feel like I don't want my audience to channel worship. It's kind of like Jesus in a way. I don't want people to worship the messenger or see me as channels and extraterrestrial, but a person who just channels higher human beings, basically. As a kid growing up, I was always a horror movie junkie, I think they call it. And yeah, I watched a lot of horror movies as a kid. And I don't know why my mom let me watch those, because I've seen a lot of shadow beings. I never really watched Freddy Krueger or Jason growing up, which is surprising. But I guess one slaughter horror movie I really watched was Chucky. But I don't know. I guess. That just creeps me out. And it got to a point where I got used to seeing shadow beings every day. And I just kind of got used to it. And every night, I don't remember every night, but almost every night when I would go to sleep, faintly wasn't a gray because she did have color in her eyes. One thing I do remember, her eyes were very beautiful. And to the side, I could kind of see outside of the door that there were kind of like bird people walking around or something. I'm not sure. That's why I'm saying I need to regain my memories as I practice astral projecting. As I start this journey, I could teach you how to astral project, but I'm not gonna really give my advice before I actually achieve it on my own, you know? Just to make sure it works, and to make sure that I'm not wasting any of y'all's time giving you advice that doesn't even work. I don't want to do that. There is this one technique that I used to do as a kid, as I actually projected it, and I didn't even realize it. And it's called the Topa technique. Let me get my notebook real quick. So, this Topa technique, it's basically a Topa is a concept of mysticism and the paranormal of a being or object which is created through spiritual or mental powers. And so, basically, as a kid, I used to be able to create beings. Some scary and some not scary. Because I still remember these beings I created. And some of these beings, they still come visit me today. I choose to travel deep into my subconscious, they will show up, and yeah, I'm going to go. And there is a way to practice creating a thought form, but in order for me to I scared. Just stay neutral the whole time as you're astral projecting. Because if you get too excited, you're gonna come right back into your body. And if you get too scared, you're gonna probably manifest scary things, and you're gonna come back right into your body. And so it's all about staying neutral and calm. Like, you basically astral project every day when you're not conscious of it. And the only difference is you're becoming conscious of it. Whether it's astral traveling within your subconscious or astral projecting outside of yourself. I feel like there's kind of a difference there, but I'm not really sure, so yeah, I think that's all I have to say, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see my new room design, I'm gonna post it on Instagram this weekend, so if you want to see that, that's gonna be my Instagram's gonna be in the description down below. And yeah, see you in the next video. Enjoy and tell me your experiences, your childhood experiences as a kid, astral projecting in the past. And what are your deepest fears?